Gaga, he cried, begging her to bring him some food. Ga cola. She screamed back derisively, but he kept calling plaintively. And after a minute or so, he uttered a joyful scream. His mother had picked up a piece of fish and was flying across to him with it. Now when the baby bird sees that his mother is, you know, busy eating food at quite some distance from him, he also requests her to give her some. But she screams back derisively means in a manner, in an insultive manner, she screams back at him that he is a stupid fellow because he is not really ready to learn when it is the time for him to learn how to fly. But when he keeps on requesting continuously, in a little while later, he sees that his mother comes flying towards him, and here he gives a joyful scream, you know, expecting that his mother is now going to give him food. But what does the mummy do? You know, holding the piece of fish in her mouth, she flies past him, right? Luring her baby to come after her. He leaned out eagerly, tapping the rock with his feet, trying to get nearer to her as she flew across. He also tries to take a few steps, not having that courage to fly, you know, and taps on a rock, trying to get closer to her so that he can grab that piece of fish from her. But when she was just opposite to him, she halted. She halted here means she stopped, her wings motionless, the piece of fish in her beak almost within reach of his beak. Means when she is right, when the mother bird is right opposite to him, she stops there in such a manner that the piece of fish is quite close to the baby bird, almost within his reach. He waited a moment in surprise, wondering why she did not come nearer, and then, maddened by hunger, he dived at the fish. Now the baby bird is getting surprised as to why the mummy bird is behaving in such a manner and why she is not giving it to him, you know, simply in a direct manner, why she is teasing him like that, holding it quite close to him, but a little away from his reach. He waited a moment in surprise, wondering why she did not come nearer, and then, maddened by hunger, he dived at the fish. Means when he does not see his mother coming nearer, he himself makes an effort to grab that piece of fish from his mother. With a loud scream, he fell outwards and downwards into space. Then a monstrous terror seized him and his heart stood still. Means his heartbeat stops. He is totally terrified. He has tried to make a big jump. He gives a loud scream because he is now almost flying, trying to balance his wings, but he is not able to do so. So that is how he is falling outwards and downwards here and there into the space. Then a monstrous terror seized him and his heart stood still. Means his heartbeat stops and he is totally terrified. He could hear nothing, but it only lasted a minute. The next moment he felt his wings spread outwards. The wind rushed against his breast feathers, then under his stomach and against his wings. He could feel the tips of his wings cutting through the air. He was not falling headlong now. Initially, you know, for a while he felt here and there outwards and downwards, but a little while later he feels that he is able to fly, and he can, you know, he is able to experience the feel of the air on his chest and on his wings, and he is now not falling anymore here and there, or, you know, on either on his stomach as well. He is able to fly somehow. He was not falling headlong now. He was soaring gradually downwards and outwards. He was no longer afraid. He just felt a bit dizzy. Means he is now able to move forward gradually. Gradually means slowly. He's moving downwards towards the sea and outwards. Means he's able to move forward He was no longer afraid. He's not at all, getting scared anymore. But he's feeling a bit dizzy. Dizzy means what? An uncomfortable feeling of spinning around and losing one's balance. The kind of, as if your head is moving round and round. That is called as dizziness. Then he flapped his wings once and he soared upwards. Ga, 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 ga. Ga, call, ah. Means he is now shouting out aloud in happiness. His mother swooped past him. His mother is also there flying right beside him to, support him. Her wings making a loud noise. He answered her with another scream. And he, when she's flapping her wings and right beside him and, support him, to teach him how to fly. He too screams and answers her back. Then his father flew over him screaming. His father also comes along flying, to support him, to give him that, moral support. He saw his two brothers and his sister flying around him, curvating and banking and soaring and diving. So his father also comes. His mother has already been flying right beside him to support him. Then his father comes and starts supporting him. His siblings also, his brothers and his sister also come flying. Curvating means, making big leaps, big, jumps. Banking means, keeping one wing higher than the other, and they're soaring, flying smoothly and diving right beside him. Then he completely forgot that he had not always been able to fly and commended himself to dive and soar and curve, shrieking shrilly. Then he completely means for, then he has completely forgotten that, he's now able to fly smoothly in the air without any problem. So he just forgets the fact that he had not been able to fly a little while ago. It seems as if he had, always known how to fly. And he commended himself to dive and soar and curve and shriek shrilly. So now he is able to fly smoothly and confidently in the air, and he is shrieking shrilly and he is enjoying it. So that is how he is screaming, giving out loud sounds. He was near the sea now, flying straight over it, facing straight out over the ocean. He saw a vast green sea beneath him, with little ridges moving over it, and he turned his beak sideways and cawed amusedly. So with the help and support of his family, he has now been able to fly successfully down towards the sky, towards the ocean, towards the sea. And now he is able to feel the, wide, vast green ocean right under him. He had come so close to the ocean that he could now see the top of those waves that were, subsequently moving in a smooth manner one after the other. He felt so happy that he turned his beak sideways and looked happily at his family and cawed amusedly, means he made the sounds full of joy. His parents and his brothers and sister had landed on this green flooring ahead of him. They were beckoning to him, calling shrilly. He dropped his legs to stand on the green sea. His legs sank into it. He screamed with fright and attempted to rise again, flapping his wings. But he was tired and weak with hunger and he could not rise. So what does he do now? His parents and his brother and sister had landed on this green flooring ahead of him. His parents and his brothers and sisters have, his sister have already landed on the green surface of the sea. And they are beckoning him. They are trying to, encourage him to do the same. Right? Desperately calling at him. He also drops his legs and, tries to stand on the sea. Tries to stay on the surface of the sea. His legs sink into water, he is now screaming, shouting with fright, with terror. He's attempting to rise above the sea, but you know, by flapping, balancing his wings. But he's so tired and he, you know, he's so weak just because of hunger that he's not able to rise, lift himself up. Exhausted by the strange exercise, fine. He's trying to do so. He also is trying exactly as his family has been doing. They have rested so comfortably themselves on the surface of the sea. He also tries, when he also tries to do, you know, the same, his legs sink into water and he is not really able to rise himself because of extreme tiredness and hunger. Right? And he feels completely exhausted because of this, you know, strange kind of a practice. His feet sank into the green sea and then his belly touched it and he sank no further. At first he feels as if he's sinking into water, but his legs only sink. And you know, when he feels the water touching his chest, he feels as if he's floating smoothly and he doesn't feel that he's sinking anymore. He was floating on it and then he realizes that he's now floating smoothly, you know, same as his family has already been doing. And around him, his family was screaming and his family also around him is screaming with happiness, praising him, and their beaks were offering him scraps of dogfish. And now that they all love him dearly, they all, you know, have got the desired result, you know, all that they wanted by punishing him, by starving him and not feeding him with food, especially his mother, all that she wanted was to learn him how to swim, how to become self-reliant, how to become self-dependent. And she has done, you know, she has succeeded in this mission. And now once they know that he has learned how to, how to learn to fly and how to finally float on water and how to find food for himself, they are now, you know, praising him by screaming around him and by offering him food to eat. He had made his first flight, and that is how, by being determined and, you know, with the help of his, with his strong willpower and with the guidance and the support, the love and the care, the encouragement of his, with the help of the encouragement that his family gave him, he was finally able to take his first flight. He was, you know, finally learned how to fly. With this, we have finished this first part of chapter number 3. Please feel free to ask if you have any queries, any questions, any doubts regarding the chapter. Thank you so much.